As a warning sign that if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose your mind. And I only want you as a focal point, so I don't lose sight of what I.
Guys, holy fuck! I just did a podcast with the cast of Brother Husbands from TLC. Woo! Guys. One wife, two husbands, a lot of threesomes. I have a lot of questions. It was the most intense, crazy, sexy podcast we've ever done, right, Jess?
So sexy.
Go check it out, soundcloud.com/shadedfriends. Bye.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Yes, welcome back to another conspiracy theory video. Now, I'm just warning you, today's video might ruin your childhood. And that's because we're gonna be talking about conspiracy theories that are all about childhood shows, toys, pretty much everything that you thought was innocent, but you thought wrong. Okay, so first we're gonna talk about toys. Now, I've talked about this a lot. I am fascinated with toys that get released to the public that have subliminal messages or that cuss. I just don't understand how that happens unless it's intentional and for some reason the toy companies want your kids to hear those bad things. Now, here's just a few more of the creepiest kid toys that have said the scariest things. And let's start with the innocent Tickle Me Elmo.
Everyone's going to be talking about this weekend. A mother changes the batteries on her son's talking Elmo doll and is stunned to hear what comes out of its mouth. You will be too.
Counting. Counting.
That's right. The Elmo doll is saying, "Kill James." That's the name of the boy who owns the Elmo Knows Your Name doll.
What? Can you imagine being a kid and having Elmo say he wants to kill you? Oh, that one is... I don't even understand what happened there. I mean, I guess the toy repeats your name, but I don't know why it started to say kill James. Either way, it's fucking terrifying. Now, that could have been a mistake or some kind of programming fuck-up, but this next one was 100% intentional. Check it out.
A mother bought her toddler this princess wand at the dollar store behind me. Imagine her surprise when the curious little girl peeled back the foil to find this image of a girl cutting herself inside.
That one is crazy to me. I mean, literally, what? Now, that one is obviously supposed to be a prank or something, but why is it in the toy section where the kids are? But even if it is some prank toy, that is really scary and fucked up.
If you look close enough, it's not a drawing. It's an actual picture of the girl slitting her wrist.
Now, there's some toys that talk, and if you reverse it, there's hidden messages. Now, there's a toy called Rufus, which is part of some, like, Monsters collection. And one woman said that when she reversed the message, she heard something really creepy.
Hi, have you ever wondered what Rufus the Monster, TY Monster, says? At the beginning, the first bit is backwards, so I thought I wanted to know what it said, so I thought I'd have a look. Ignore the first bit. So it says, "Rulof thinks you're so pretty. I've got my eye on you, boying."
I don't even know what to say about that one. Literally, "I've got my eye on you," and then a boner sound. So it makes me wonder, what's the point of this? You know, are the children's toy companies trying to put subliminal messages to somehow get into your kid's brain? Or are they just having fun and they think it's funny to put these like dirty messages in kids' toys? Either way, it's really fucking creepy, but sometimes it is kind of funny. Some of the toys that repeat what you say don't have a filter on it, so whatever you say, it will say it.
Say something and I'll sing it back.
Fuck bitches get money.
Okay, I love that one. I actually would buy that. Okay, so now we're going to talk about some things that are hidden inside of movies and TV shows that we never caught. And we're going to start with Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. So obviously, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory is a family film about a crazy guy who owns a candy factory, and he invites a bunch of kids over to eat candy and play around and eventually kills them off one by one. Wow, that sounds really fucked up when I say it out loud. Well, anyways, as you probably remember in the movie, there was a moment where he wanted the kids to lick the walls. Check it out.
Go ahead, try it.
Mmm, I got a plum.
Grandpa, this banana's fantastic. It tastes so real.
Try some more. The strawberries taste like strawberries. The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
Now, obviously, snozzberry isn't a real thing. Like, in my head, when I was watching it, I just imagined some crazy berry that was sour and sweet. But snozzberry actually is a real thing, and it's not food. So Willy Wonka is based on the book that was written by Roald Dahl, and he wrote another book, and here is an excerpt from it. "There's only one way when they get violent," Yasmin said. "I grabbed hold of his snozzberry and hung on to it like grim death and gave it a twist or two to make him hold still." Yeah, snozzberry is slang for a dick, which changes a lot of things when you rewatch that part of the movie.
The strawberries taste like strawberries. The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
He's telling the children that they taste like dick. That is just like, I love that one. So that one was disturbing, but kind of funny. These next ones are just disturbing. Now, I'm sure you guys know the show The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, which was on the Disney Channel. It's a show about two boys that lived in a hotel and had fun. Now, the show's on the Disney Channel. Why would there be anything crazy hidden in there? Well, as you guys know, Disney has some of the craziest things hidden in their movies and TV shows, and this is no different. In one scene where the boys are in class, if you pause it and look at the chalkboard behind them, you will see something crazy. What? Literally, it says the Illuminati. Right there. Why would that be there? What would the purpose of that be? But this isn't the only kid show that has Illuminati symbols. I mean, first of all, The Fairly Odd Parents is covered in Illuminati symbols. I mean, people have been screenshotting those ones for years. The kid's alter ego name is Timmy Triangle, which is literally the symbol of the Illuminati. Now, even on the show DuckTales, if you freeze the picture, you'll see in the background, there's an eye chart that says, "Ask about Illuminati." But then, in another shot, the letters have been scrambled, and it doesn't say that anymore. So clearly that was on purpose. They wanted that one shot where it said "Ask About Illuminati," but then they didn't want it in any of the others, which makes it even more feel like it was subliminal. So you're probably wondering why. What's the point of this? The whole point of the Illuminati putting their symbols on shows and movies and music is to claim their territory. Almost like how a dog pees on certain things that he wants to claim as his own. The Illuminati wants to claim television, movies, and music. And they're doing a pretty good job. So next time you're watching a kid's show, be on the lookout. Maybe there'll be something in the background. Okay, now this next one is a theory about the show The Flintstones. So The Flintstones was a cartoon that aired back in the 1960s about a family that lived in the prehistoric times. Or did they? There's a theory that the Flintstones actually live in the future. Now, I know what you're thinking, the future, they literally live like cavemen. Well, what if there was a nuclear war, and what if the Flintstones were just one of the many families that had to start over? Now, this theory makes sense considering the show was created around the time of the Cold War, and that was when Americans were terrified of Russia sending a nuclear attack. So maybe the creators of the show were inspired by that and thought, what would it be like if we had to start from scratch? So this would explain a lot of things, because number one, why were the Flintstones doing things that looked like things we do? I mean, just look at this clip of the Flintstones creating a record player out of a bird and a stone.
Okay, let's spin a disc.
Now, if this is a prehistoric cave family, how do they even know what a record is? How do they know what a record machine looks like? How would they know to create one? And not only that, they have TVs made out of rocks. They have Christmas trees and Christmas parties. How do they even know what Christmas is? They have banks. They have fake money. They even at one point put on wigs and played guitar and pretended to be the Beatles. Well, is that because all of these things are what they knew before the war? Are they trying to recreate society as they remembered it? Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably thinking, I don't know, Shane, you're overthinking this. They just were probably having fun, and they were like, oh, it'll be so funny to see a bird that's also a vacuum, or a shower that's made out of an elephant trunk. But I think it's more than that. I think these show creators were very smart, and they wanted to say something. They wanted to say, hey guys, look what could happen if we go to war. And that could still happen with what's going on in the world right now, so get ready to be watching YouTube videos on a rock. Okay, so we talked about the Illuminati putting creepy things inside of movies and TV shows, but let's talk about a lot of other hidden messages. Now, some of these I found out about, I couldn't believe that we didn't catch it. Just look at this clip from the movie Harry Potter, and in the background, sex is written on the wall. Check it out. Yeah, literally on the wall. Right there for all of us to see. What would the point of that be? Why? I mean, were the producers just having fun and thought it would be kind of funny? Or were they trying to put sex in your kids' faces? But this isn't the only creepy thing that I've seen in a Harry Potter movie. I mean, just look at one of the characters' costumes. Now, the character Bellatrix Lestrange, I might have butchered that name. If you look closely at her costume, you will see that there is a 666 right by her hand. I mean, that one's just literally right there. Like, they clearly put that there for a reason. So it makes you wonder, what else is hidden inside of Harry Potter? Probably a lot. Okay, now speaking of Harry Potter, this next one involves the Harry Potter world and also a terrifying show called Teletubbies. Now, I've talked about the Teletubbies before. They fucking scare the shit out of me. I never understood why kids watched it. It literally is the creepiest people, creature things running around looking fucking terrifying. And don't even get me started on the big baby sun thing. We've talked about that before. It's horrifying. Well, here's a couple theories about the Teletubbies. So what if I were to tell you that there is a link or correlation between the Teletubbies and Harry Potter? Well, the first link is obvious. The Teletubbies were on the BBC, Harry Potter is from the UK, so that already is a link. But look closer at the actual Teletubbies. Let's look at the yellow one. What's on his head? Looks like a lightning bolt. And then on the purple one's head, triangle. The green one's head, a straight line. And the red one's head, a circle. Now, who else had a lightning bolt on their head? But if you take the other three and you put their symbols together, you get the symbol of the Deathly Hallows. I mean, come on, that one is fucking crazy. There has to be a link. I don't know why or why they would do this. Now, I've never actually seen the Teletubbies because I'm too fucking terrified, but I can't even imagine how many more symbols there are in that show. And I'm not the only one that feels that way. When that show originally came out, people petitioned for it not to be shown to their children. Parents believed that the show was trying to brainwash kids. And one of the reasons they said that was because the theme song repeats the same thing over and over and over again for no reason. And parents thought, that was a way of turning on the brainwashing effect on their kids. Similar to hypnosis, if you repeat something enough times, maybe you can start to get in there. In case you forgot, here's a clip of it.
Time for Teletubbies. Time for Teletubbies. Time for Teletubbies. Time for Teletubbies.
I don't know, that shit sounds like some straight up brainwashing to me. Also, just to ruin your childhood even more and give you fucking nightmares, I don't know if you're aware of this, but the Teletubbies are not small little fun creatures. In real life, the Teletubbies are 10 feet tall. Look at this picture. Look at that. Look at the tall man next to them compared to how tall they are. That's fucking horrifying. Imagine these huge 10 foot tall beasts running around the grass, frolicking and rolling around and playing. Literally the scariest thing I can imagine. I mean, just imagine seeing Teletubbies out in the real world and what they would look like. That is what nightmares are made of. Now, in the same theme of hidden messages and stuff, this one literally changed my life. I cannot unsee this. Now, look at the Taco Bell logo. Just take a look. Yeah. We know that logo. I definitely see that logo a lot. Well, get ready, because I'm about to change your fucking life. Now look closer at the bell in that logo and think about a reptile eye. Literally, I cannot unsee it. That's a fucking reptile eye. I don't care how you spin it or how many of you were like, Shane, you're crazy. Look at it. That literally is a reptile eye. Just put it next to a reptile eye. Look at the side by side. Oh my god, that one. Ooh, that one gives me the fucking chills. And that's one that's so crazy to me because it's been there my whole life and I've never seen it. So it makes you wonder who's in control of fast food? Who's in control of the whole fast food industry? Maybe it's the reptile people. Okay, now this last theory involves Disneyland, which I could do a whole video just on that. But as you guys know, a lot of bad things happen in Disneyland. I mean, there is a long list of people that have been decapitated on a ride, crushed to death, thrown from a ride. There have been so many unlucky things that have happened at Disneyland. And it makes you wonder why. Well, maybe Disneyland is haunted. Now I know you're thinking, Shane, why would a theme park be haunted? It's so fun and there's rides and food and big Mickey Mouse is running around and smiling. Well, what if I were to tell you that there's also thousands of dead bodies? All right, now let me explain. Supposedly, Disneyland is one of the most popular places for people to take their relatives' ashes and spread them. Now, back in 2007, one woman was kicked out because she was seen dumping some kind of ashes into the water of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride. So next time you go to Disneyland, think about the fact that you might be breathing in dead people. But also think about this, all of those dead bodies, all those ashes, what if the reason that people die on rides at Disneyland is because the dead bodies that are already there want more? What if they just want more people like them at the party? Well, two of the rides at Disneyland that are known to be the most haunted are the Haunted Mansion and It's a Small World. And guess what else those rides are? Those are the two most popular places at Disneyland that people throw their ashes. Whew, another reason for me never to go to Disneyland. There you guys go. Hopefully you enjoyed all of those conspiracy theories and just creepy stories about your childhood. And I just want to say I'm sorry if you are now triggered every time you drive by Taco Bell, because I know I am. Alright, you guys, if you want more conspiracy theory videos, please give me a thumbs up so I know. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel right down below and hit the notification bell, because I make new videos every day. And if you want to see my other conspiracy theory videos, I'll put a link to a playlist right at the top of the description below. Alright, you guys, look out for hidden symbols, because they are everywhere.